So you're stuck at home, you're calling into meetings, using video conferencing software to talk to your team, and you might be wondering how to make the most of your video conferencing setup. Well, I've got just the tips for you and a little sneak peek into what I've been doing at home, so stick around. Hey everyone, welcome back to Today in Tech. Today we are talking about video conferencing software, Zoom, Skype, Teams, WebEx. Name your video conferencing software. I'm gonna help you make the most out of your setup. So if you've been calling into all of your meetings, maybe utilizing video software just so you can physically see other people on your team, it could be really nice to make sure that you've got a clear picture and clear sound. If you're just relying on your laptop or desktop webcam and microphone, it's definitely not the ideal setup, but we still have some tips and tricks for you. Rule number one, you want to be in some sort of quiet location. I'm here in my parents' basement. The rest of my family's upstairs working, and it's pretty quiet so far. Anytime that I've been filming, I've asked them to not walk super loudly upstairs and limit letting the dogs inside and out. But whatever works for you, works for you. A closed door, maybe you just tell your family, hey, I'm gonna be on a call for a little bit. Can you please move your conversations to another room? Use headphones if they have meetings, etc. Another way around this is to use some sort of headphone microphone combo. Maybe you have a headset, or maybe you even just have those old Apple headphones that would come with your old phones or even like iPods, and they have that little microphone attached here and you can plug them in. So people will hear you through that mic and you'll be able to hear them through your headphones, which could limit some feedback. And maybe you've noticed some of your colleagues filming themselves in front of huge windows and you can barely see their face. Quick and easy tip for that is to make sure that the light is in front of you. You can't see right now, but I've got two lights right here, and that's making sure that my face is always illuminated when I'm going to be doing Skype video shoots with some of my colleagues in the coming weeks. So you've got the basics mastered, you're in a quiet location, you asked your family very politely to be quiet, and you're making sure that you have your headphones on so you can hear everyone on the call clearly. Next up, you might be ready to invest in some video conferencing hardware. Maybe it's a webcam, an external microphone. Even the most basic stuff is probably gonna be better than whatever your desktop or laptop computer is offering. And finally, if you are ready for the most advanced setup, I'm gonna go over what I'm doing. So I've essentially turned our super nice Canon C200 camera into my webcam. And that's using a very handy little piece of equipment. It's the Elgato Camlink 4K. And I'm using that to connect my camera to my laptop computer. So when you guys are gonna see those future Zoom interviews, I'm gonna have some really crystal clear quality video because I'm actually using this super, super nice camera. And in my laptop, that's where I'm going in Zoom and selecting my camera for both my microphone and my webcam, essentially. So I'm using an HDMI cord to run from the camera to the Elgato and then plugging it into the USB port on my computer. And it's actually a really convenient and easy setup. You guys are gonna get to see some of it in the interviews in the coming weeks. It looks pretty nice. So once I've gone into Zoom, selected the appropriate microphone and camera, and both of those are the Camlink 4K, the way that I'm hearing my guests are with these giant headphones. You may recognize them from our in-studio shoots. I also hauled these all the way back to my parents' house, and I'm putting these on. That way I can hear my guests through my computer, and there's not gonna be any feedback because they're not gonna be coming out of my computer speakers. So if you've got a laptop or desktop computer with a USB import and an HDMI to HDMI cord and a relatively good quality camera, you could absolutely replicate the setup at home. We'll be sure to link the Camlink down below, and it's a super, super easy setup. Seriously, couldn't be easier. I wanna know what you think, and I wanna hear what your video conferencing setups look like, so be sure to leave a comment below letting me know, as well as leave any other tips that I may have forgotten. I know I and your fellow viewers would really appreciate it. Thanks again for watching. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and please also leave a comment below if you have any requests for future videos. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.